One of Sydney's most trusted and respected driving instructors has given a grim assessment of young drivers. He says many are being allowed on the road totally unprepared. So, to see if he's right, Christian De Garis has joined a group of P-platers on a steep learning curve.
If this was real, two pedestrians would now be dead or seriously injured. These P-plate drivers are learning to react safely to obstacles on the road.
Heartbeat stop there.
Were you expecting that?
No, it's a shock.
We need to be awake. We need to be vigilant.
Ian Laugh has been training new drivers for decades and is worried they're hitting the road unprepared.
I believe the driving test at the moment is inadequate. It's only doing things like a reverse park, a three-point turn, and a lap round the block. That does nothing to equip young drivers or any driver with the skills needed to drive to survive.
Jared Ingram agrees. He spent 7 months in hospital after wrapping his car around a tree.
Rehabilitation is lifelong for a person with a brain injury.
In New South Wales, 13% of our drivers are P-platers, but they make up a staggering 22% of people killed this year. These drivers don't want to become a statistic.
Went a bit far then.
Yeah, I forgot to stop. Because I was like, neutral! But I forgot to stop.
Is it a bit nervous?
Oh, a little bit.
I reckon every kid that went home today from this course would go home thinking, gee, and I thought I knew it all.
Having long removed the P-plates, I thought I'd give it a go.
Stop the car, stop! I was definitely a little bit more nervous than I expected. I can see why the kids get a lot out of it.
Maybe it's time for a refresher. Christian De Garis, 10 News.